5.0 out of 5 stars. Delivers on what it promises, just make sure you understand what it promises. In reading the reviews for this product, I've noticed that some people may have been expecting something more than what Cuisinart is selling. Having used this unit several times now, here are my impressions and thoughts. The unit uses a freezer bowl to freeze the product. That means that the bowl must be frozen solid and the product must be very well chilled, otherwise you will not get good results. We have just kept our freezer bowls in the deep freeze when not in use so that we can make ice cream fairly quickly. It's probably best to mix up your soft serve mix at least an hour in advance and put it in the coldest part of your fridge or, as another reviewer suggested, in the freezer for 10 to 15 minutes to get it as cold as possible without prematurely freezing it. The freezer bowl doesn't have a huge capacity. It can make 10 to 12 servings, if your servings are small. 6 to 8 is probably more like it. If you want more, make certain you purchase an additional bowl and keep it frozen. The instructions on time expectations generally say 10 to 15 minutes, and this can be true if you chill the ice cream mixture very thoroughly. Otherwise it will take longer, probably more like 15 to 20 minutes. The first serving or so may be fairly soupy. I have found that I can dispense some into a cup and then re-add that into the top of the bowl. The mix-ins really don't mix into the soft serve at all. They are really topping dispensers. If you're expecting something like a DQ blizzard, it's not the same. Also, don't overfill, or pack in, the mix-in bins. I've had good luck with chopped peanuts, sprinkles and the mini M&M's. The differences between this unit and a more conventional ice cream freezer are mainly that this unit has a freezable bowl versus a bowl that is placed in a mix of ice and rock salt. That means it is a little more convenient, but lacks the capacity of the conventional freezer. Our ice cream freezer makes about twice as much ice cream as the soft serve, but it is much louder, generally requires more cleanup and doesn't dispense the product. On the other side, I think a conventional freezer has more versatility if you are making things like frozen custards that set up harder than soft serve. Finally, the freezer just isn't really as much fun as this one is, which has real appeal if you've got kids in the family. Overall, I've really enjoyed this gadget, but I did some research first and made certain I understood what I was buying. This is not like the soft serve dispensers in restaurants, but it's very nice for a treat on a summer afternoon. 4.0 out of 5 stars. Cuisinart Ice 45, practice makes perfect. For soft serve and ice cream cone lovers, this Cuisinart Mix-It-In soft serve machine is a fun and effective kitchen gadget with the novelty of 3 built-in topping dispensers. Follow the instructions and adapt the recipes and you can get tasty soft serve comparable to your favorite soft serve shop. If you've been doing your homework, you're apt to become confused, as I did, as to the reason why so many reviewers rave about this machine whereas the other half claim that it simply doesn't work. Most complaints seemingly center around the fact that the bowl must be frozen. And if your freezer doesn't have the space or doesn't get cold enough, it is nearly impossible to obtain desirable results. For the money, consumers seemingly expect that these machines will refrigerate the soft serve ice cream, but they don't. Yes, you can buy ice cream makers that self-refrigerate the ingredients as they mix, but those generally cost much more, do not produce soft serve and do not offer a dispenser. In other words, apples to oranges. I feel fortunate to have read reviewer tips from successful owners here on Amazon prior to purchase. Had I not, I too may have been among those who are disappointed with the product. Instead, I learned that while the user manual suggests freezing the bowl for 15 hours, May 24th be necessary, toward the back of the freezer. Better yet, if you are able to store the bowl in the freezer, it makes it much easier to use the machine spontaneously. I also learned something the manual does not suggest but should. Mix up the ingredients using a wire whisk or low-speed mixer at least 20 minutes ahead of time and chill the contents in a pitcher, along with the mixing paddle, for a bit more before you remove the bowl from the freezer, pour in the contents and switch on the machine. The name of the game is to minimize time sitting out on the counter warming up. The colder the ingredients and the faster you get them into the bowl, the less time it will take to bring the contents up to the desired consistency. The user guide indicates that it may take 20 to 30 minutes to attain finished results, whereas the box claims as few as 15 minutes. I personally found doing all of the above resulted in ice cream shop soft serve consistency in about 18 minutes. By 26 minutes it was so thick that it was difficult to dispense, at which point the user manual suggests scooping it out of the bowl and serving that way. Also important to understand is the fact that if you fail to turn off the machine, the soft serve may become so thick that a circuit may switch off the motor to protect it from overheating. This is not a defect but something plainly stated in the manual. So for those who are curious to know if it can be left running to produce hard-packed ice cream, the answer is absolutely not. Because there is no timer on the machine, it is entirely up to the user to determine when it is time to dispense the contents, a period of checking that begins 15 minutes into the process. This is by far the trickiest part about the machine's operation and the likely source of most complaints. Way too little and the consistency is not much better than a milkshake. Way too long, and the dispenser can no longer propel the ice cream through. The window of opportunity to dispense the entire contents of the bowl may be as little as 5 minutes, assuming you like your soft serve on the thick side and push it to the last few minutes before it is too thick to dispense. One way to get the consistency you desire is to take a measuring cup or small dish and periodically dispense, test, from about 15 minutes onward, every minute or so. If it is too runny, dump it back in the bowl. If the soft serve holds its form, it is ready to serve. There are certain kitchen electrics that involve a learning curve and this Cuisinart soft serve machine is no exception. I own a Carnival popcorn maker, movie theater style, an espresso machine and a bread machine, each that required me to adapt to particular design and operation characteristics for best results. If you understand what you are getting and for that I suggest prospective buyers download the owner's guide at the Cuisinart website before placing an order, you won't be disappointed. If this machine doesn't seem to live up to its billing, it may stem from internet descriptions that would have would-be buyers believe this is an ice cream maker. The badge on the machine clearly designates it foremost as a soft serve machine. And for that purpose it is a lot of fun, complete with choice of 3 topping dispensers. Where the toppings are concerned, I discovered that there is no way to adjust the rate of flow, which is why I'm docking this product 1 star. Toppings tend to dispense too fast and are best reserved for bowls and not cones. They tend to scatter and a bowl can catch them much better than a cone can. In terms of cost effectiveness, there are some recipes, typically the more exotic variations, that can cost quite a bit more than just treating yourself to an ice cream parlor. Basic recipe ingredients, however, are cream, sugar, milk and flavoring, which won't set you back too far. Using yet another tip I read here on Amazon, I reduced sugar content on Cuisinart's basic vanilla and the results using French vanilla extract for flavoring were light, fluffy, and silky smooth without ice crystals. And therein lies my final tip, until you get the hang of this machine, go by the book. Literally. Once you get the operation down pat using the included recipes, branch off into internet recipes, ingredient substitutions, or whatever else captures your imagination. In this way you can easily distinguish between a faulty machine, an inadequately frozen bowl and a recipe that isn't suited for soft serve machine use. In closing, soft serve lovers should not be dissuaded by negative reviews. As for giving this away as a gift, particularly to a child or anyone who lacks patience in the kitchen, I would think twice. Not everyone will be intrigued by the dispensing features or the novelty of spending that much time making soft serve at home. Although dispensing the condiments and the soft serve is somewhat of an art, it is worth the effort for anyone who prefers their ice cream extra light, fluffy and slash or served in a cone. How many machines offer features like this? Only one other non-discontinued product that I'm aware of. As the wildly different reviews attest to, however, this machine is not as foolproof as other kitchen electrics. Success relies upon eyeballing the mixture through the cutout in the lid. And while you're at it, if you want to avoid a messy drip, you must make sure to return the lever back into the up position each time you finish dispensing. Otherwise the soft serve flow will not be entirely closed off and you will have soft serve in the drip tray to show for it. Bottom line? Practice makes perfect. 4 comments, 412 people found this helpful. Was this review helpful to you? Yes, no report abuse, 5.0 out of 5 stars, wonderful soft serve machine. Totally worth the money, by Goldberg family on October 19, 2007, color, white, verified purchase. We just used this machine tonight, and we are very pleased with it. I read through all the 48 other comments on this page before buying, and was a little daunted by the negatives, but we promised the kids to get the machine, so we took the plunge. Thought we would need a second bowl since we have 7 kids, but found it not so. We used regular sized Keebler waffle cones, piled to the top but not beyond, and everyone got one, even mom and dad, with a couple of the bigger eaters getting seconds. Here are my observations. 1. The bowl gets plenty cold if your freezer is plenty cold. Folks down below who claim they had cold freezers and their bowls didn't get cold enough, don't know what to say about them. Cold is one of those things that either it is, or it ain't. Enough said. I started dispensing after 15 minutes, because I was afraid the bowl would start warming up, but as I got to the last cones, I noticed the ice cream continued to harden and look more professional as it dispensed. Next time I'll wait until 20. After the bowl had been out of the deep freeze for 40 minutes, we rinsed it in hot water, and the water froze solid to the bowl. That's cold. 2. The mix-in thingy worked perfectly. I couldn't believe how neato that was. Follow the directions on sizes, and you won't go wrong. 3. I took the advice downstream and avoided the Cuisinart recipes. We just used our family favorite old-fashioned vanilla, with the raw eggs, flour, salt, sugar, milk, and cream. No problems. I made our usual 6 or so quarts that we put in the full-sized ice cream freezer, so we have leftovers for tomorrow. Final analysis, cold freezer, follow directions. That simple. Sucker works like a charm. I had kids hugging me and thanking me for buying the machine, it doesn't get much better than that. 5.0 out of 5 stars. Delivers on what it promises, just make sure you understand what it promises. In reading the reviews for this product, I've noticed that some people may have been expecting something more than what Cuisinart is selling. Having used this unit several times now, here are my impressions and thoughts. The unit uses a freezer bowl to freeze the product. That means that the bowl must be frozen solid and the product must be very well chilled, otherwise you will not get good results. We have just kept our freezer bowls in the deep freeze when not in use so that we can make ice cream fairly quickly. It's probably best to mix up your soft serve mix at least an hour in advance and put it in the coldest part of your fridge or, as another reviewer suggested, in the freezer for 10 to 15 minutes to get it as cold as possible without prematurely freezing it. The freezer bowl doesn't have a huge capacity. It can make 10 to 12 servings, if your servings are small. 6 to 8 is probably more like it. If you want more, make certain you purchase an additional bowl and keep it frozen. The instructions on time expectations generally say 10 to 15 minutes, and this can be